Hello, everyone. My name is Pastor Dave, and I want to welcome you to our 2021 First Fruit Offering Daily Devotional. All of us have heard the term tithe in the church. To give a tithe means that we give a tenth of our income or our increase back to God, and we do it through our church. Now, tithes are given to the church throughout the entire year and are used to support the ministry. The tithes are used by the church to cover operating expenses and are also used to help people who are in need. Now, first fruit offerings are something a little bit different. Let's take a look at the scripture found in Nehemiah 12 and 44. It says, "On that day when men were appointed to be in charge of the storerooms for the offerings, the first part of the harvest and the tithes, they were responsible to collect from the fields outside the towns the portions required by the law for the priest and the Levites. For all of the people of Judah took joy in the priest and Levites and their work." Now, in the old days, harvest time was significant because that's when their hard work, their hard labor, all the tough times they had pouring into their crops all year was going to pay off. They were literally reaping what they sowed. Now, God called his people to bring forth the first yield, or what we call today first fruits, from their harvest to him as an offering. Now, this was to demonstrate the Israelites' obedience and reverence for God. It also showed that they trusted God to provide enough crops for, you know, left over to feed them and their family. God made them promise a promise for their obedience. And we look at Proverbs 3, 9, and 10. It says, "Honor the Lord with thy substance and with thy first fruits of all thine increase. So shall the barns be filled with plenty, and thy press shall burst out with new wine." Now, the most significant aspect of first fruit offering was the reason behind it. It was designed to acknowledge and thank God for providing the Israelites with the land flowing with milk and honey after their captivity in Egypt. The Hebrew word for first fruit is bikurim, and it literally means, or is translated to, promise to come. Now, the Israelites saw the first fruits as an investment into their future. God told them that if they brought their first fruits to him, he would bless all that came afterwards. First fruits is mentioned throughout the Old Testament, but it's also referenced in the New Testament. Let's take a look at 1 Corinthians 15:20. It says, "But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead. He is the first of a great harvest of all who have died. God gave Jesus his best, who was raised from the dead, up for us, in the same way that we sacrifice our best for him." Romans 8:23 says, at least the first part of it, "And not only the creation, but we ourselves who have the first fruits of the Spirit." Listen, as in other passages, Paul is using first fruits as a metaphor for the first appearance of a promised blessing. Remember that, promised blessing. Now here, it is the Holy Spirit, or the Helper, who Jesus promised in John 14:26. The very first followers of Jesus were the very first to experience the blessings of the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. They received the first fruits of the Holy Spirit's work in the lives of the believers, just as we do today. Now, first fruit offerings are typically an annual gift to the church today, done at harvest time. Now, because we're not actually harvesting crops, the harvest can mean different things to different people. Perhaps you just got a bonus at work. Maybe you just received a huge tax refund check. Maybe you saved 15% more on your car insurance. And these are not commercials, these are just examples. These are all harvest time moments when your hard work has paid off. There are also great opportunities to turn back to God in gratitude for those blessings. We celebrate our first fruit offering here, the first of the year, in January, at the end of the month. Now, giving our first fruits means giving our best to God and putting him first. making a first fruit offering opens us up to allow God to work in our life. When we approach God with open hands rather than clutched or clenched fist, it makes it easier for Him to give us more to work with. Now, giving our first fruits reminds us that God is our ultimate priority. He's number one. It shows God that we are obedient to Him and we can be trusted with more. Do you believe that everything God has given us or has given you is from God? I hope so. But perhaps the most importantly of the reasons, being generous in this way shows that we are grateful for all that God has done for us. When we make our first fruit offering, the important thing is that we do it freely, with no guilt or obligation. This is supposed to be a celebration of all that God has done for us. A first fruit offering is our opportunity to give above and beyond just the regular tithe that we normally give. It is interesting that there are two motives for giving the first fruit offerings. And when I read the scripture found in Nehemiah, the first motive was that the people were looking for a blessing for themselves. The second motive, I think a lot of people miss. The second motive was at the end of that scripture, and it was that they wanted to bless the ministry. Let's take look at that scripture one more time. It says that in that day, men were appointed to be in charge of the storerooms for the offerings, the first part of the harvest, and the tithes. They were responsible to collect from the fields outside the towns the portions required by law for the priest and the Levites. Now listen to this. For all the people of Judah, it didn't say some of them, it says all of them, took joy in the priest and Levites and their work. The second motive is they wanted a blessed ministry. When we look at the scripture in Nehemiah, we are also reminded the people gave with great joy because they remembered the hard work and dedication of the priest and the Levites. Now let's just bring this up to date. When I look at our leadership here today at The Way, I'm reminded also of the hard work and dedication of our leaders. We have pastors, we have ministry leaders, we have people that God has put in position that work really hard. They work with a good heart, and they love God's people. I am so grateful that God has given them to us, and I consider it an honor to serve them, not only in ministry, but also in tithes and with my offerings and first fruits. God bless you. I hope this helped you, and we'll look forward to seeing you again.